and welcome to the first installment of FDA's Women's Health video blog. My name is Uchenna Alexander, and I'm a project manager here at FDA, where I work on communications projects.
And I'm Leslie Maloney. I'm a pharmacist here at FDA. And Uchenna and I got involved with this project because we think there's a great number of resources here at FDA that might be of interest to you women across the country.
This blog is going to be available on our website, www.fda.gov, as well as our transparency blog, which is at fdatransparencyblog.fda.gov. You can also reach us by email at webmail@oc.fda.gov.
And for our first video blog, we wanted to talk about women's heart health. February 4th is National Wear Red Day, and that's where women across the country are going to be wearing red to show their support for women's heart disease awareness.
In addition to wearing red, it's important for women to be aware of their heart health and to be knowledgeable about the ways in which we can prevent heart disease in ourselves.
That's right, and women often have different warning signs and symptoms than men. For example, women might not have chest pain. Instead, they might have achy, tight, or heaviness. And it might, rather than being just in the chest area, they might have it in their back or in the shoulder area. Women could also have trouble sleeping, might feel sick to their stomach, could have pain in the belly area or just above the belly button, and could have new or worsening headaches. And one of the most important signs for heart disease is feeling tired, even after you've had a good night's sleep.
Well, that's one that I didn't know, but I do know about being tired. As a new mom, I have a 6-month-old daughter at home. Hi, Michelle. And because of that, I feel like I haven't slept in about 6 months. But I guess that means it's important for women like me to keep track of how they feel. And if you feel tiredness or fatigue that you can't attribute to something like staying up all night with a newborn, it's probably important to talk to your doctor.
Talking to your doctor or other healthcare professional is definitely a good idea. You should be making sure you're having regular blood pressure and cholesterol checkups, and you need to know if your family has a history of heart disease. And there are steps that you can take on your own. Make sure you're eating right, eating that healthy, balanced diet, exercising, and that you're maintaining a healthy weight for your size. And if you're a smoker, it's time to quit.
Time to quit.
There are a lot of materials on FDA's website, so check them out. fda.gov/womensheartshealth. There you might find anything from tips for healthy eating to how to manage your high blood pressure if you have diabetes.
And remember, if you have any comments or questions about this topic or suggestions for other topics that we can cover in the future, you can leave those comments at fdatransparencyblog.fda.gov or email us at webmail@oc.fda.gov.
Thanks for listening in, and tune in next time.
Take care.